Hey, it's Jacob here with the Pool Supply. Just want to go over with you today how to set up your iAqualink 2.0 from a mobile device. So let's go ahead and get started. So on your iPad, iPhone, Android, however you want to use it, go to your App Store and then pull up on your App Store. The easiest way to get to it is just to do a search. Android has a search bar, Apple has a search bar, top right for Apple. So you're going to want to type in iAqualink. And then it's going to be your choice right there. I got to click search, so let me get back to it and search. So pretty much it's going to pull up the iAqualink. It's got the I currently. They might change it down the road. So I'm going to download it. And you might type in your Apple ID or Google Play Apple ID or Apple ID, Google Play ID and password. But go ahead and download it. And then when it's all downloaded, go ahead and open the app. So here is the Zodiac iAqualink app. So what we're going to do is we are going to sign up for a new account, because I'm just going to show you guys how to get yourself credentials and everything online. So pretty much an invite code right here. It's for an IQ pump. You're not going to do that, so you're going to say register new. And then it's going to ask you for all your information. You have to just fill out the stuff with all the stars next to it. First name, last name, email, password. Firm password, the whole nine yards. It's real fun. So Mr. Pool Guy. And then just type in an email address. Your email address is what you're going to use to log into the app with every single time. So it doesn't have to be like your best email address or anything like that. You just kind of type in whatever you want to type in for to log in every time. But they're going to send you confirmations. That's how you recover your lost password as well. So make sure it's something you do use. And then your password is right there. And then type in a postal code. I'm just going to make one up real quick. So then Alabama. Why not? We're going to live at 123. Sorry, this takes a little bit of time to get you all registered. But again, the registration process is good for Zodiac to have, because let's say you're purchasing a house that already has one of these. You can call them up, tell them where you live, tell them your name, your password, the whole nine yards, because it's always registered to your router or your network, I should say. And what it is you can kick old people off if you want to by calling their number and doing that. You can also do it on their web application as well. So, all right, so now we're connected. So what we're going to do in the top right, there's a plus arrow. So what we're going to do, actually, we want to set up the iAqualink to the Wi-Fi. So let's set up the iAqualink antenna to the Wi-Fi. And what it is you're going to go to your Wi-Fi, and you're going to search. So pretty much your antenna actually has a Wi-Fi signal. So if you see down, it says iAqualink, and it has the last three of your serial number. You're going to click it, and all of a sudden, a new pop-up screen will automatically pop up. The iAqualink takes over your device, and what it is right here, you're going to see a list of networks. Poolboy is our network we want to attach onto, so you click it, and then you type in your password, which is extremely case-sensitive, so make sure your Wi-Fi password is the correct one, case-sensitive as well. So we're going to type in Zodiac69, and we are good to go. So connection progress, we're going to want to exit out of this screen and go back to our iAqualink device, our web screen for iAqualink app. And so now we're going to click the plus arrow on the top right, and it's going to ask us to add an IQ20, IQ900, that's what we want to do. And then device number. So let's see, your device number is located on the side of your iAqualink antenna, right there, and it's also on the side of the paperwork that came with the box. So there's another little sticker right there of your iAqualink antenna. So we're going to type in our device number, and then this is what's gonna get us online. So if you remember back at that other screen that says also said IQ Pump, be sure to log in to our YouTube channel and take a look at our how to install your IQ Pump. That's just a standalone system if you want to actually just control only your pump from your iPhone. It's a really cheap, easy controller to use with a variable speed pump. It's really cool, actually. So now that we typed in our credentials, right here is going to pop up. The yellow dot is not good. That means our system is in service or timeout mode. So I'm going to go press the button. make sure we get back into auto mode, because you cannot use your app if it's in service or timeout mode. So what we're going to do is refresh our system now that I just turned it back into auto, which is green dot, which is great. And it automatically opens the page, shows everything on or pumps on, and it's going. I mean, this is your it. This is it. So, I mean, so everything's working good. We are now controlling our pool from my iPad or iPhone. And so here's the Jandy color light. You can choose whatever color you want. And then also what you can do is in the top, there's a web button, or I think it's in the bottom now, actually, a web button. And that will actually pull you up to this screen. So now this is the full capability of programming, setting your whole system up. You can see the statuses. If you go into menu, you can actually click on the schedule. You can adjust your schedules of when everything's running. And it's pretty cool. There's a lot of capabilities with iAqualink, and I'm sure that there's more to come with your capabilities of using iAqualink. Thank you for choosing ePool Supply. We look forward to serving all your installation and video needs for all of your pool equipment. Thank you, and visit us at epoolsupply.com and now poolinfloor.com.